Okay, I did not expect it to blow up this much and so many important people to notice it. But a lot of people wondering how exactly was this made. So we use everyone's favorite cone for this, VLC media player. It is a scene video filter which sends every frame into a picture file. This flooded my pictures folder with a lot of these images. So now we try to find a space to put all the towers. In this case, the most empty map was Blonde's. It has more space than firing range. And we can fit about 22 by 18 ice monkeys there, which was coincidentally about the same aspect ratio as the video. Now we move it out of the screen to 420x420. Then we get the original image, which is at 360p, and then we try to convert it into the 22 by 18 frame. So we using ratio, we can get the exact pixel we want to toggle the specific tower location at, so we get the pixel color. If the red component of the color is greater than 128, which is white, then we move the ice to the location. If not, we move the bomb, which is black. So this works for one frame, but we want to animate it. So on left click, we load an image and move the towers according to the pixels. And then we hook up an auto clicker to click on this, and you'll move the towers accordingly. So how long did it take? So it's automatic, and it did not take surprisingly long, because moving towers is not as laggy as you would think in BTD6, even if you're moving like 396 of them. So here is the original speed. In like lifetime, it took about 16 minutes to animate all the frames. And that's about it. Thanks for watching.